Hello guys, and welcome to the Classic Car Show 2023. Today we're starting off with the Lamborghini Miura SV. Lamborghini are celebrating their 60th anniversary this year, so I'm expecting to see a lot more of these types of cars as the year goes on. In this vlog, I am actually trying out a new mic, so let me know what you think if it comes across okay. Any feedback will be welcomed. Porsche is celebrating their 60th anniversary of the 911. And this is the very first version, the 901, the cleanest version. I actually like this, but my favorite is the 964, which still resembles this car in many ways. But of course, pretty much 90% of the car was new. The 911 Turbo, which is the first variant of it, is synonymous with Porsche and the 911. Here we have the 964 version of the 911, and as you can see, it's very similar to the original car. Porsche did rework the entire thing compared to the 911 Turbo 930 version and the 901, but it still has that original look. Here we have the 993. With this version, they actually made the very first GT product, the 993 GT2 as it's called, but it's actually referred to officially as the 911 GT. Here we have the 996 911. This is the GT3 variant. This car is not, 996 is not really a loved version of the 911. I'm a fan, especially in this variant. It just looks cool. The Lancia 037 Evo 2 variant. This was the last rally car with rear wheel drive to win the world championship. Actually looks really small in person. It's quite surprising. It's been a while since I've seen one of these. Here we have a Porsche 917K replica. This is a road legal car. Although it's a replica, as far as I know, Porsche do use these cars when they're doing demonstration runs because it's so good. And the fact that this is road legal, can you imagine driving this down the road and seeing it on the road as well? It just looks so special. This could possibly be the most famous Ferrari 360 Modena in the UK. Is seen through glasses car on display here at the show. I've never seen an exposed chassis of a 300 SL Goldwing. It looks stunning in many ways. At the same time, it's so simple. Here we have a fake Bugatti Veyron. But guess what, even though it's a replica based on an Audi R8, it costs £240,000. I mean, that is ridiculous. I don't know who's going to spend 240 grand on a fake. I have to say, the front looks really bad on it. Definitely not convincing as a Veyron. We're at the Ferrari Club UK, and the first car we're looking at is the F40. Did you know that Enzo came up with the idea for the F40 to celebrate the 40th anniversary of the company in 1986? And by 1987, the car was already ready to be unveiled at the Frankfurt Motor Show. Just 1 year it took them to come up with this car. That's amazing. Next to it is this black Testarossa, the perfect color for this car. Moving on. We have another 360 Modena. Here we have the Michael Schumacher edition of the 550 Maranello. This is the way Michael Schumacher spec'd the car, and they decided to make it a special edition. One of the things that makes this car special is the interior. It's got a rollover cage, race harness. Of course, it's got the manual gearbox. Just the way I like it. The Ferrari Owners Club has some great cars on display. It's a shame that the club doesn't allow Ferrari fans to join the club. You have to be an owner of the cars, unlike Lamborghini, which you don't have to be an owner to join the club. What is going on here with this Mercedes SC? I mean, how slammed is that? I love the interior though. A hope you can hear me over the speakers, but I have to get this car into the vlog. This is a 1974 Fiat 500L Abarth with an Alfa Romeo engine in it. I mean, just look at it. Look at how wide the wheel arches are. I think here we've got the lineup of the show, starting with the Ferrari GTO, next to the F40, next to the F50. Now, I often think that this is the car that I would choose from the five super limited series cars. But then when I look at the F40, I think, no, I'll take that one. And then I look at the F50 and I think that's the one I would want because of the V12. It's really difficult to choose between them. Which one would you choose? I'm going to end the vlog here, guys. We've got a Porsche Carrera GT looking really good. However, I must admit, this show has been a bit of a disappointment. There have been some cool cars here, but there's not been a lot. And I think for the price that we paid to get in, it's a bit too much. Maybe next year they have something better, but if it continues like this, I don't see the show going on for much longer because people will be disappointed. I know I am. So if you enjoyed this vlog, please click like and subscribe. There's a lot more coming. Hopefully the shows coming up this year will be a lot better. And let me know what you think of the mic that I'm using. And I'll see you next time. Bye.